This week at NASA.
The seven-member STS-131 crew continues to prep for its April mission to the International Space Station. Flying aboard the Space Shuttle Discovery, the crew will deliver about 13,000 pounds of supplies to the station.
Now, this is a great crew. If I had to pick a crew, this would be the crew I would pick. I mean, without a doubt, they're just great folks and super skilled and very, very professional and just a joy to work with every day.
STS-131 will mark the first time two astronauts from the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency are in space together. Mission specialist Naoko Yamazaki and Expedition 23 flight engineer Soichi Noguchi will meet up aboard the ISS.
This is a very big step for Japan. Of course, for the American astronaut, it is usual. However, for the Japanese astronaut, it is the first time to get together in space. And Soichi and I are scheduled to do several tasks together, like experiment rock transfer and installation of the space station. So we are looking forward to working each other. And we are also looking forward to sharing some Japanese cultures among the crew members.
Okay, maneuver started. Copy.
NASA's Stratospheric Observatory for Infrared Astronomy Aircraft, SOPHIA, completed a two-week series of flight envelope expansion test flights. Flying with its telescope cavity door open, the modified 747 was put through a variety of maneuvers to gauge its handling and identify potential problems with vibrations and buffeting. NASA test pilots also flew simulated landing approaches at 15,000 feet altitude to evaluate aeroacoustic effects of having the 16-foot-high telescope door open while the aircraft is in landing configuration. When its initial science missions begin later this year, SOPHIA will conduct world-class astronomical observations in the infrared while cruising at more than 7 miles above ground.
I just want to thank you all for choosing to recognize Brenda, because she is a champion, and she has been incredibly helpful to me in the brief period of time that I've been the NASA administrator. So, Brenda, would you come forward, and I thank you for what you do.
Brenda Manuel, NASA Associate Administrator for Diversity and Equal Opportunity, was honored by the Society of Women Engineers as this year's recipient of the group's President's Award. A lawyer by training, Manuel was recognized for her longtime encouragement of women to pursue careers in the STEM fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
Creating and maintaining welcoming and inclusive STEM environments in which equal opportunity can thrive is crucial to increasing the number of women and minorities in the STEM pipeline, and thereby expanding the available talent pool.
Manuel is responsible for developing and directing the agency's equal opportunity, civil rights compliance, and diversity strategies, programs, and processes.
The final support beam for the Ames Research Center's new green building was installed during a special topping out celebration. Traditionally, an evergreen tree and/or flag is placed on the last beam lifted into place, signifying the structure's final height and completion of its iron skeleton. When built, Sustainability Base will incorporate new energy-efficient technologies to make it one of the greenest and highest performance federal buildings in the country. It will be highly intelligent, even intuitive, anticipating and reacting to changes in sunlight, temperature, wind, and usage. Among the innovative features will be a water recovery system developed by Ames scientists that will reduce potable water consumption by 90%.
First the moon, now the stars. Former moonwalker, Apollo astronaut Buzz Aldrin has again captured the nation's attention as a contestant on the ABC television series Dancing with the Stars.
My name is Buzz Aldrin, and on July 20th, 1969, I was one of the first men to walk on the moon.
Aldrin was teamed with professional dancer Ashley Costa, a Stars veteran. Aldrin was spurred on by NASA astronauts Jeff Williams and T.J. Creamer in a surprise message from the International Space Station.
Buzz, we know that you're an original moonwalker, but can you still do this move?
Go. On June 20, 1969, Aldrin and Apollo 11 crewmate Neil Armstrong became the first humans to set foot on another heavenly body.
Beautiful view.
Isn't that something?
And that's This Week at NASA.
For more on these and other stories, log on to www.nasa.gov.